In this tutorial, I will show you how to simulate agarose gel electrophoresis in SnapGene. Simulating agarose gels is a useful tool to predict the appearance of bands on a gel following restriction digests or PCR amplification. Within SnapGene, I have a file containing a PGL4 plasmid that includes the interleukin-6 gene promoter. To simulate agarose gel electrophoresis, go to Tools, Simulate Agarose Gel. A new window will open showing the agarose gel simulation in the top left, information about the lanes below this, and the map view of the file on the right. By default, the agarose gel shows 10 lanes. By using the drop-down menu, you can change the number of lanes to 12, 16, 20, or 26. I will leave this as 10 lanes for now. In the first lane labeled MW, this refers to a molecular weight marker, or DNA ladder. By selecting this in the list, I can specify a different marker by using the drop-down menu. If the marker you're interested in is not listed, you can select Edit Molecular Weight Markers List to browse additional markers. Molecular weight markers have their bands automatically labeled on the simulated gel, so you can easily interpolate any DNA band sizes. The PGL4 plasmid I had open is automatically placed in lane 1. And since this is a circular plasmid, the initial result shown is that of supercoiled DNA. Migration of supercoiled DNA is known to behave differently in different electrophoresis buffers. So SnapGene allows you to change the buffer used in the simulation to align with your experiment. Currently, the buffer is TBE. However, if I select this, or select the Agarose Gel Preferences button at the bottom, I can change this to TAE or SB buffer. Notice how the band in lane 1 changes as I switch buffers. I will leave the buffer as TBE and return to the agarose gel by closing the window. I will now see what the agarose gel looks like when the plasmid is linearized. To do this, I will select lane 2 and I will use the drop-down menu to select the same PGL4 plasmid. To simulate a digest, I will ensure the top drop-down menu states Cut Width, and then select up to 4 different restriction enzymes by using the other drop-down menus. Alternatively, I can click on the enzymes in Map View to select an enzyme, or Shift-click to select multiple enzymes. I want to make this plasmid linear, so I will select to cut with a single unique plasmid, in this case, XHO1. Now, the product in this lane is linear. Notice how this fragment appears different to that of the supercoiled version. In the next lane, I will again select the PGL4 plasmid, but this time I will cut with the three enzymes XHO1, HindI3, and BAMH1. I can now see that there are three bands in lane 3. If I click on a band in the gel image, or in the list view, this fragment will be highlighted on the map view. So that's an overview of simulating restriction digests on an agarose gel. Next, I will show you how to visualize products following PCR amplification. So I will select lane 4 and open a file called sec13pcr. This file contains the sequence of the Saccharomyces sec13 gene, as indicated by this feature, with some flanking sequence either side of the feature. To simplify the view, I will turn off the restriction sites. As you can see, there are two PCR primers that are designed to anneal to the start and end of the sec13 gene. To learn more about designing primers in SnapGene, refer to the primers and PCR video tutorial. To visualize what this product would look like on an agarose gel, I will change the drop-down menu at the top to Amplified by PCR. I can then use the drop-down menus at the bottom to specify the two primers to use. Alternatively, I can shift-click on the two primers in the map view to select them. The amplified product of 894 base pairs can now be viewed on the simulated gel. Other aspects of the simulated agarose gel that you can adjust are the gel concentration and the running time. By using the drop-down menu, you can change the agarose percentage of the gel, and this can range from 0.5% to 4%. Additionally, by using the slider to the right of the gel, you can change the simulated running time. Sliding the bar up will shorten the running time, and sliding the bar down will lengthen the running time. And once you're happy with your gel, you can either print or export the image. To print the image, click on Print Gel and select to print the standard gel image or an inverted gel image. Alternatively, the Copy/Export Gel Data drop-down menu will allow you to either copy or export the gel, inverted gel, or fragment list. I will choose Copy Gel Image to copy this to my clipboard. Now I can open a different software and paste this in. And that wraps up this video tutorial. In this video, you have learned how to simulate agarose gel electrophoresis by using SnapGene. For other SnapGene tutorials, check out the other videos on the SnapGene website.